annealing is probably the first step in processing this material, and then kiln drying it, which you're at an advantage because it's free of all of its inbound moisture. You can, if I'm just working on inventory, I try to take a mental note, and we'll have an order for say 100 square feet of tap house, and I know I cut like 300 square feet, but you know there's a pattern. Like if we went and we tore that barn down, the whole one side of the barn is going to look similar. People don't want that similar appearance usually. When they're ordering tap house or weathered gray, you know, they want some consistency or inconsistencies to make it even more unique in certain situations. So we get different barns in, and I have to mix them together sometimes. And it's denailed, it's ripped, and it's within a 16th. It should be right on. I've measured these with calipers. That saw that we have is fully capable of, you know, right on the money, so why not? One thing, you know, what we talked about earlier is I don't brush it too much. Of course, I will brush this section, and this is the fine brush. I'll give you an example of how I can, you know, if I brush it too much, that's taken away from the color, and you can start seeing some brown come out.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't want to take the patina off there because it's taken, you know, that long for the patina to get there and the weathering. This board was once smooth. It didn't have any weathering, it didn't have any color. It was actually looked like that, you know. It's really difficult to identify the species when it's, you know, hasn't been touched. It hasn't been, nothing's exposed there. You know, people cherish giant trees because they were all harvested. So there's a few around, and this board being, you know, what is it, 14 or 13 inches wide, the tree was enormous. I don't even know the timber that you're sitting on right now. These trees are, you know, to find a tree like that, I mean, you can see these trees here, they're obviously not going to yield a board of that dimension because this was once round. It was a big round log, and so they had to square it. So this, you have to go out here when you start imagining how wide the tree was, how big this tree was. Never goes out of style. It's that type of, it's a feeling. You can't really describe it. It's like when you look at an antique, you just see things and you like, you just see the richness of it, the appeal. You're like, I like it, I want, you know, I want that.